Welcome to my channel, Ken here. Today, let's take a look at the genome by two notes. Let's go. I felt like it would be useful to take a look at the opening cue or opening track that I have on this video, because genome is all over it and multiple instances. So the guitar is a quad track and nothing has been rendered here. So I find this genome to be pretty easy on the computer resources, and it doesn't add a huge amount of latency, although everything else does. So what I have here is essentially four rhythm guitar tracks, two leak tracks, and one clean channel. Since everything here is mono, I processed a lot of this actually with additional genomes in post-processing, or in the group tracks. So let's take a quick look at this. So here's the clean channel, and on that I use this Gemini, clearly a Fender type amp. It's modeled after. I have a little bit of compression on it here, and I have a Blonde 63, which is part of their basic pack, and I have a Ribbon 21 and a Condenser 87, Neumann 87 and a Royer, and then I have a chorus, and this would be mono because it's a mono track. So let's hear that. Wait, let me solo this. So the reverb is post-processing here, and I'm using a Cinematic Rooms on it as a stereo reverb. On next up is this intro lead here, and I used Green Meanie. I guess that's some kind of tube screamer. And this Nifty 65, which is their brand new update to the software. This is the new amp model after, I guess, a PV6505 maybe. And then I have a Uber cabinet with a 121 Royer and a 57 on the cabinet. And you can see I have the Ribbon a little bit outside to give it a little bit of room. And this is what that sounds like. So the post-processing is this guy, which is on the group track because I want it in stereo. So it's being routed out to a group track or bus. And you know, I EQ'd a little bit, put a stereo delay on it, and their reverb. And they all sound really good, I have to say, as you can hear. So here's the track soloed. And here's the main lead right here in the middle. Again, another instance of Genome. And here I have the wah going, the Green Mini Tube Screamer, the same amp again, the new one, the Nifty 65, and the same cabinet is set up the same way as the intro lead. So this is what this sounds like. And post-processing out into the another group track, and here's some more EQ and delay and reverb. So you can see I just have a touch of delay on it and the reverb, and you can see the amount is very small, but it all adds up. Now to the rhythm guitars, I'll just find a spot here we can use. They're all the same, essentially. So you have the Green Mini. That's turned off even. And here's the amp. Same new amp, Nifty 65. And then the cabinet here. Right, same deal, except I have an 87, but yeah, it's just a touch of the 87 to give it a little bit of space. So that's essentially how I did this. All these rhythm guitars are then routed to a group track. And on that group track, I have this guy as a group EQ. That's it. There's nothing else here. It's just to EQ a little bit. Turning it off. Just control slightly, turn down slightly the palm mutes and give it a little bit more top end. Pretty subtle stuff. That's the track here, and nothing is rendered. That's the thing. No guitars, no drums, no bass. I didn't render anything, and it's running it just fine on my computer. Please leave a comment below about this Genome guitar suite and let me know what you think. Okay. So here we have an instance of Genome, and I have the Green Mini on it, the Tube Screamer. I have a compressor on it before it hits the amp, like it's super subtle, but I'll get into that. I have the Nifty 65, which is a modeling of the 6505, I take it, but based on, they call it. So that's a PV, and then there's a cabinet here, where I have a 121 and a 57 on it, emphasis on the 57, and then a little bit of EQ at the end. So let's go over this for a second. So this is what it sounds like. So it has a little handy gate here. And then it has a tuner. It that I'm playing a Schecter SLS. It was an early model of it. So, a couple of things. The chain I'm using is from the guitar into a Shelford channel, which is basically the Rupert Neve design direct box into the audio interface, which is an Aurora N, and then it gets directly into the computer into two notes. Let me try another one here. So here I'm using the, they call it the flatback, but it's clearly based on a rectifier by a Mesa Boogie. So I'm doing the same thing here. The tube screamer, compressor, the flatback, same cabinet, and a little bit of EQ. So first, let's see how it sounds. This compressor. So you can see I'm just touching it, just ever so slightly. It's really, really, really subtle. 3-to-1 ratio. It just touches. I'm going to turn it off. So I find it helps a little bit with getting it to feel more than it sounds like a real amp. It just, there's that little bit of interaction between the guitar and the amp that gets a little more, feels a little bit better. Try the other amp again. As you can see here, it's pretty hot looking on the computer, but because I'm basically running it at 64-bit, there's no overs here. It's just, it sounds a little bit better when the signal is hot to me. Let's take a look at the cleans. So again, I have the compressor here, a little more compression, the threshold is set lower. You have the Gemini, which is a Fender-ish amp, the Blonde 63 like the other track, and then the mono chorus on it. want to get back to this Nifty 65. Thanks to Two Notes for sending this plugin over to me for testing. There's a lot of good things to say about this thing, but first I want to mention that it replaces the Wall of Sound. Wall of Sound was the old version of Genome. It basically had all the cabinets and it had effects in it and power amps and a bunch of other stuff. But they decided to abandon that and then come out with this new Genome. I'll leave a link below to a video where I just used the power amp and the IR packs as a plug-in for a pedal. So that's what the Wall of Sound could do in the past, but and it can still do the same thing, but now they're adding a bunch of amplifiers to it. So I figured they'll change it all up. Essentially, it retains all the old Wall of Sound effects and stuff like that that I didn't show in this video, but all the new stuff, the amps and a bunch of new effects is very welcome. I think this is a full feature suite, and I'm a little bit shocked about how affordable this is, under $100, which is amazing. I think they all sound good in this, and I think they're very light on resources, which is also welcome. So all in all, I think this is a great plug-in suite that can be used in a variety of ways, just for the effects alone, but never mind the IRs and the amplifiers and stuff like that. They're all very, very good, and it's all very, very well done. And I also think it's much better designed and much more intuitive and more mainstream the way they designed it, and it certainly looks a little bit better. But unfortunately, I still have my old Torpedo Studio sitting here, and the Wall of Sound could kind of double up as an alternative to the Torpedo or hold the same settings, especially for IRs and effects. So this one can't do the same thing, so I guess it's time to move on. But all in all, I have to say good things about this. Although I'm not a plug-in guitar sim kind of guy, I like my real amps, but this one is one of the better ones I've tried. So I do recommend it, especially for the price. It's ridiculously priced, I think. So go and get it just for the effects alone, but the amps are great too. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe. And until next time, take care.